I'm going to show you how to do RMI, remote method invocation, using Java. I found some images on the internet that explain its principles. The process involved clients and servers. The clients and servers could be in different machines. The client will invoke the server objects, the remote server objects. Now, for this to work, the clients have to know where the remote objects are located. So before any communication, a server has to register itself in the RMI remote registry, which is cached in the memory. And this process is called binding. So the remote object has to bind itself to the registry first, and then the client can look up the remote object from this registry, and then it invoke the methods, and the server would carry out the computation and return the results. Yeah. Now here's another diagram that shows how it works. So we have a client communicating with a server, and the server has to bind itself to the registry interfaces, and the client looks up the remote object from the registry, and it has to use a stub, which is generated by RMIC, a program provided by Java. It uses this stub to communicate with a remote object through the RMI runtime, and the server would use a stub to extract the information and carry out the activities and return the results. Now, I'll use a very simple example to explain the process. I'll use a simple hello example to do the explanation. Okay. Now first, we create the remote object interface, say hello. Hello is an interface. An interface means it is a class without the actual implementation. The implementation is carried out or is done by its children, the subclasses. So this interface has to extend remote, which is in java.rmi.remote. And if error occurs, it throws remote exception. So this is the interface. It only has one method, say hello. So we can compile this to make sure there's no error. So it compiles, and now we implement the server. So this is the server. So the server implements hello. So the server is a subclass of hello. And so it implements this say hello method. It is very simple. It does not do much. It gets the host name using this method, using the class innet address, and to get the host is host name of itself, and send the message hello from say its host name to the client or for the calling method. If error occurs, it will send the message hello from unknown host. So this is say hello. This is the main of the server. First, I create the object server and also generate a stub. Using unicast remote object export object, using this stuff, okay, the hello, and then you bind the remote object stuff in the registry using the bind method, and then it prints out the message server ready. If error occurs, it prints out server exception. So it is very simple. Server compile it, then finally the client the client does not do much. Within the command argument, if the no argument is supplied, then the local IP address is used. Otherwise, it uses the IP address provided by the command, input command. And again, it get the host name using the remote host, using get registry. And look up the hello object, and then call or invoke the remote object, say hello. So we get the returned string and put it in response, and we print out the response, which is the message from the server, the hello from the host name. If error occurs, then it prints out the exception message. So this is the client, we compile it. Okay, so we have written all the required programs. Now before we can do any remote invocation, we have to start the registry. So it should be RMI registry, start as a background. But you can see that command not found. That's because the path is not in our environment. So we locate RMI registry. So we can use say this one. We copy, paste, and start as background. So the registry has been started, and now we can start the server, which will register itself. Java server. Okay. So the server is ready, and now we log onto another machine, JB358, okay, and start the client. But we want to find the IP address of the remote machine. Typing this. So the remote IP is 149.182.148.121. So now we can type in Java client 149.182.148.121, and you can see that the response or the string sent back from the remote object is hello from jb359-1.csusb.edu. So that's from this server. Okay. So you can see that how the remote method is invoked. Okay, thank you, bye-bye.